What did you think when you saw Senator Elaine Morgan's comments?
I was horrified. I mean, it was really disappointing, very disappointing, because it wasn't, you know, factual, and it was misinformation, and it was just disappointing that, you know, your reaction to a humanitarian issue would be to say no, and to revert back to practices that we have learned lessons from that were not, you know, in the best interest of the country or the people that, you know, that it served.
And how do you think the voters of your former district think of what she said?
I do not believe. I've had people reach out to me, and they too are very disturbed by her response and her release of that email. It does not represent the district, and it does not represent the district.
Do you think someone who holds those views should resign? Should someone with those views be representing the people of your district, the people of Southern Rhode Island?
Well, I'm not going to, you know, go that far, but I think that I don't believe that it represents the district at all. You know, I don't believe those views represent the district.
I would imagine if there is any doubt in your mind, this will certainly inspire you to challenge her in 2016.
Of course. It is so not my view, and not the how I would like to see us as a state or country embrace these people that are in crises. And so I think that we need to, you know, to represent both our state and country in a better light of who we are as Americans.
How do you think this will play into your campaign? Do you think it will help you or Senator Morgan?
I would guess that the people in the district are very disappointed with her reaction.